Hello everyone and welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We're glad you're tuned in. We want to give a shout out to our friends at Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove Network. Thank you for hosting us on your station. In the Medford School District, we have one shared vision, and that we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better place to do that than right here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
What's up, everybody? It is Teacher Connor here with Miss Britt from the Learning Loft Preschool and Kid Time Children's Museum, and we have another day of awesome things to bring to you. Now, I know that Miss Britt is also very excited today, and I'm not sure why. Miss Britt, why are you excited?
Do you know what today is?
Today is Tuesday?
No. Today, Teacher Connor, is color day.
Oh, that's awesome. What's color day?
Oh, it's my very, very, very favorite day of the whole entire year, because on color day, you bring all the things you need to create a colorful masterpiece.
That does sound pretty awesome. What things do you need?
Okay, here's what I brought today in order to create a colorful masterpiece. I brought my color mixing palette. I brought my collection of paintbrushes. I brought my canvas, and I brought all the colors of the rainbow. I brought yellow, red, and blue. I'm ready to go.
Oh. Miss Britt?
Yeah.
Do you want to tell him or should I tell him? All right, I'll tell her. That's not all the colors of the rainbow.
Oh, no. Teacher Connor, it's totally fine. I have yellow, red, and blue. And with those colors, I can paint anything I want. That's all I need. I just need those three colors.
Oh, okay. Sure. What are you planning on painting?
Oh, I have so many ideas. Purple dinosaurs, red robots, pink umbrellas. I think I might paint some black mushrooms.
Oh, so Miss Britt, I love the ideas. Those are some awesome ideas. How are you gonna paint a purple dinosaur?
Oh no.
Well, you know, it's actually okay, because I happen to have on me a book that has seen me through many years of my early painting days that I could read to you to help kind of maneuver through some of these colors. And then you could make any color you'd like with those.
Whoa. You're telling me that with the colors yellow, red, and blue, I could make all the colors I need in order to make my colorful masterpiece?
For the most part, yeah.
I would love to see this book.
All right, everybody. I have brought this mouse paint book by Ellen Stoll Walsh, which has seen me through my early painting days and through my veteran painting days. And through it, we shall learn how to mix colors. You guys ready? Here we go. Once there were three white mice on a white piece of paper. The cat couldn't find them. One day, while the cat was asleep, the mice saw three jars of paint, one red, one yellow, and one blue. They thought it was mouse paint. They climbed right in. Then one was red, one was yellow, and one was blue. They dripped puddles of paint onto the paper, and the puddles looked like fun. The red mouse stepped into a yellow puddle and did a little dance. His red feet stirred the yellow puddle until... Do you know what's going to happen next? Do you know what happens when you combine red and yellow? Let's find out. Look, he cried. Red feet in a yellow puddle make orange. Good guessing, guys. The yellow mouse hopped into a blue puddle. His feet mixed and stirred and mixed until... Any guesses on what yellow and blue is going to make? Look down, said the red mouse and the blue mouse. Yellow feet in a blue puddle make green. Interesting. Then the blue mouse jumped into a red puddle. He splashed and mixed and danced until... Let's see, blue and red, what does that make? Mm-hmm. Purple, they all shouted. Blue feet in a red puddle make purple. But the paint on their fur got sticky and stiff, so they washed themselves down to a nice soft white. Uh-oh. Do you know what that says? That says cat. And painted the paper instead. They painted one part red, one part yellow, and one part blue. They mixed the red and yellow to make an orange part. Yellow and blue to paint a green part. And blue and red to paint a purple part. But they left some white because of the cat. Thanks, guys. All right, Miss Britt. So we just read the book on color mixing, and I think we're ready to dive into mixing the colors themselves. Do you feel ready?
Kind of, Teacher Connor. I have the three colors that I started with, and I don't know. I think I might need some help.
Don't worry. We'll take this step by step. So first, what you're going to do is pop one of those colors into your color palette wheel.
Okay. Awesome. I'm going to start with my yellow right here. Mm-hmm. Done.
Nice. Now you can go ahead and pop the other colors, making sure that you get them right in the circle.
Mix them all together?
Nope. You're going to put one color in each circle.
Oh, okay. A little bit of red and a little bit of blue.
Perfect. So that's about half the battle right there. So now what we're going to try out is mixing some of those colors. So I heard you say before that you wanted to make a purple dinosaur.
I have no idea how to make the color purple, though, Teacher Connor. I've never done this before.
Not a problem. Do you guys remember what colors we mixed together in the book to make purple? Perfect. Let's try those out. Okay. So we're going to try to mix our blue.
Okay. I'm going to take a little bit of blue on my paintbrush. And I'm going to put it right here on my canvas.
And now you're going to add a little bit of red.
Okay. I'm going to grab a little bit of red and just mix it with the blue.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, here we go. Something's happening, Teacher Connor.
What's happening?
Teacher Connor, it worked. I did a little bit of red and a little bit of blue, and it made purple.
Awesome. Perfect. Fantastic.
This is so cool.
Awesome. Now, what other colors would you want to make?
I was really, really hoping to make an orange field.
I think we can do that. Do you guys remember how to make orange? Exactly. Now, we need to first get a little bit of red this time.
Okay. Got a little bit of red.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Perfect. And instead of using the blue this time, what we're going to do is we're going to use yellow.
Just yellow.
Mm-hmm.
I just add yellow to the red, and it's gonna make orange.
Theoretically.
I don't know about this. Do you guys think it'll work? Okay, here we go. Oh my gosh, Teacher Connor.
Mm-hmm.
Something's happening.
Mm-hmm.
It's happening. It's orange!
How cool is that?
Gosh, this is amazing. Okay. I don't see how this could be possible, but I really want to make green.
It's a pretty useful color. Now, do you know what colors we have to add to make green? That's right. So you're going to start off with yellow this time.
Okay. A little bit of yellow.
Mm-hmm. And this time you're going to add blue. They're the ones that said it.
Are you sure? Okay, here goes nothing. I'm adding some... What?
Right away, we have results, ladies and gentlemen.
This is incredible. Yellow and blue make green.
Mm-hmm.
Who knew?
Pretty awesome.
Okay. This is really cool and all, but Teacher Connor, I made all the colors. I followed your directions from your book, but there's still a couple colors that we have not made yet that I really wanted to make.
What colors could you possibly want to make?
I really want to make pink.
I think we can make pink. Do you guys know how to make pink? So, in order to make pink, which is what the next color you want it to be is, we have to...
Whoa, Teacher Connor.
Yeah?
Something's wrong. We're seeing green here where we mixed it.
I see it.
But our friends at home, they're not seeing green. Are you guys seeing green on my palette?
Oh, I'm looking at our screen now and you're right. That isn't green. Oh.
I know what's happening, Teacher Connor. Our friends at home, we're in a film studio right now. And when you're in a film studio, you use this really, really, really cool thing. And it's really cool we can show them this on color day. You use a thing called a green screen. Should we show them?
I think we should. Mr. O, which is our executive producer here, would you mind switching us to the green screen?
There's my green screen. It's so cool. Teacher Connor, do you have a green screen?
I think so. Oh, there's mine.
And the green screen is this wall behind us, and it's painted all green. And anything that goes in front of it that's green disappears.
Mm-hmm.
Should we show them?
Yeah, sure. Here, hold on. So I have this piece of green tape here. You see how it's green? And once Mr. O turns back on the other picture, this is going to disappear.
Whoa! Teacher Connor, it's gone.
Yeah. Should we, Mr. O, can you switch it back to the green screen? See? Just a piece of tape. All right, let's go ahead and put that screen back on me.
Whoa! Isn't that cool, you guys? In our film production studio with Mr. O, we can do all these really, really, really cool things. But unfortunately, it does make our green paint kind of disappear. You can see it now, but when he turns back to my screen, oh, it's gone. So can you pretend that green paint's there with us when we'll make our pink paint now?
All right. I think we can handle that.
Cool.
What you're going to need first is a little bit of white paint.
Okay.
Alrighty. Perfect.
Okay.
And now you're going to mix that with a little bit of red paint.
Oh, I get it, because it will kind of lighten the red paint, won't it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's try mixing those together with one of my paint brushes.
Whoa.
Teacher Connor, it's working.
Pretty awesome.
We made pink.
Perfect.
This is so cool.
Do you guys want to know another cool trick that you can do with colors? You can make them darker by adding black, which I happen to have delivered to your desk over there as well.
Got it. Thank you so much. So just add a little bit of black to these colors.
Mm-hmm. So why don't you try to add a little bit of black to that one there?
Okay. I'll just put a few dots and we'll mix them together and see what happens. Oh, wow. It's kind of a dark purple now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Let's try it with this orange and black. Oh, kind of made brown.
Sometimes that happens when you mix a lot of colors together.
Okay, I'm going to try one last one. Oh, it kind of made of gray, pinkish gray color.
Mm-hmm.
That was super cool, Teacher Connor.
Awesome. Did you guys have fun? Awesome. Hey, everybody. I have brought a book today called I Ain't Gonna Paint No More. And what's cool about this book is we can actually sing it. You guys ready? Here we go. One day my mama caught me painting pictures on the floor.
and the ceiling and the walls and the curtains and the door. And I heard my mama holler like I never heard before. You ain't gonna paint no more. Well, I ain't gonna paint no more, no more. Ain't gonna paint no more. That's what I say, but there ain't no way that I ain't gonna paint no more. So I take some red, gonna paint my head. Now I ain't gonna paint no more.
Do you guys think you could find your head?
Very good, all right. What the heck gonna paint my neck? Now I ain't gonna paint no more.
Where's your neck?
There it is. Still I just can't rest till I paint my,
what rhymes with rest? Chest.
Now I ain't gonna paint no more. Yes, there ain't no harm if I paint my arm.
Can you guys find your arm?
Very good, very, very good. Now I ain't gonna paint no more. I ain't gonna paint no more, no more. I ain't gonna paint no more. But I just can't stand till I paint my hand. Now I ain't gonna paint no more. Very good job. Then I see some blacks gonna paint my,
what rhymes with black? Oh, back.
Back. Now I ain't gonna paint no more. Like an Easter egg gonna paint my,
what rhymes with egg? Ooh,
leg. Like an Easter egg gonna paint my leg. Now I ain't gonna paint no more. Still I ain't complete till I paint my,
what's connected to my leg that rhymes with leet? Oh, feet.
Now I ain't gonna paint no more. I ain't gonna paint no more, no more. Ain't gonna paint no more. I got such a nut gonna paint my,
what?
Well, y'all don't faint cause there ain't no paint. Now I ain't gonna paint no more.
Thanks, guys.
Hi, everyone. I brought one of my very favorite books with me today, The Day the Crayons Quit, and it's all about colors. And since it's color day, I thought we should probably read it. Do you want to read it with me? All right, here we go. The Day the Crayons Quit. One day in class, Duncan went to take out his crayons, and he found a stack of letters with his name on them. Here's the first letter. It says, "Hey, Duncan, it's me, Red Crayon. We need to talk. You make me work harder than any of the other crayons. All year long, I wear myself out coloring fire engines and apples and strawberries and everything else that's red. I even work on the holidays. I have to color all the Santas at Christmas time and all of the hearts at Valentine's Day. I need a rest. Your overworked friend, Red Crayon." "All right, listen here, Duncan. I love that I'm your favorite crayon for grapes, dragons, and wizard hats, but it makes me crazy that so much of my gorgeous color goes outside of the lines. If you don't start coloring inside the line soon, I'm gonna completely lose it. Your very neat friend, Purple Crayon."
"Dear Duncan, I'm tired of being called light brown or dark tan because I'm neither. I'm beige and I'm proud. I'm also tired of being second place to Mr. Brown Crayon. It's not fair that Brown gets all the bears and ponies and puppies. All I get are turkey dinners, if I'm lucky. And wheat. And let's be honest, when was the last time you saw a kid excited about coloring wheat? Your beige friend, beige crayon. Dear Duncan, you color with me, but why? Most of the time, I'm the same color as the page you are using me on, white. And if I didn't have a black outline, you wouldn't even know that I'm here. I'm not even in the rainbow. I'm only used to color snow or to fill an empty space between other things. And it leaves me feeling, well, empty. We need to talk. Your empty friend, White Crayon. Hi, Duncan. I hate being used to draw the outline of things. Things that are colored in by other colors, all of which think they're brighter than me. It's not fair that when you use me to draw a nice beach ball, and then you fill it in with all the other colors. How about a black beach ball sometime? Is that too much to ask? Your friend, Black Crayon. Dear Duncan, it's been great being your favorite color this past year and the year before and the year before that. And I've really enjoyed all those oceans, lakes, and rivers, and raindrops, and rain clouds, and clear skies. But the bad news is that I'm so short and stubby, I can't even see the railing in the crayon box anymore. I need a break. You're very stubby friend, Blue Crayon. Duncan. Okay, listen here, kid. You have not used me once in the past year. Is it because you think I'm a girl's color? Speaking of which, please tell your little sister that I said thank you for using me to color in her little princess coloring book. I think she did a fabulous job of staying inside the lines. Now back to us, kid. Could you please use me sometime to color the occasional cowboy, pink dinosaur, or monster? Goodness knows they could all use a splash of color. Your unused friend, Pink Crayon. Hey, Duncan. It's, me, Peach Crayon. Why did you peel off all the paper wrapping? Because now I'm naked and I'm too embarrassed to leave the crayon box. I don't even have any underwear. How would you like to go to school naked? I need some clothes. Help! Your naked friend, Peach Crayon. Well, poor Duncan, he just wanted to color, and of course he wanted his crayons to be happy. And that gave him an idea. When Duncan showed his teacher his new picture, she gave him an A for coloring. And an A plus for creativity. Thanks, guys. Thank you guys so much for reading The Day the Crayons Quit with me. It's really one of my very favorite books. But you know why, Teacher Connor?
Why?
It's not just because it's a funny story with crayons and we get to read all of their letters. It's also because it reminds us that coloring has no rules and it's all about creativity and you can really do whatever you want when you color. Do you want to do a no rules coloring challenge with me?
Absolutely. What are the rules?
Oh, no. Teacher Connor, there are no rules.
Oh, okay. So there's like a manual or like a rule book or something, or do we have to look up the rules online?
No, Teacher Connor, when you color, there's no rules. You can color whatever you want with whatever color you want.
Huh. Okay. I guess I should get started, huh?
Yeah, give it a try.
Okay.
Just pick any color you want and color whatever you want.
Sure, sure. Well, I'll make a house and I'll, of course, use a black outline.
Oh, Teacher Connor, remember in the book, the color black, he was like, please don't use me as an outline anymore.
Oh.
Use me for something fun. So try another color. It doesn't have to be a black outline.
Hmm. I have an idea. What if I used pink?
That's a great color.
I do love pink. All right. Let's see. I'll do a pink house. A little strange, but I'll go for it.
It's awesome.
Nice, nice. And I'll do, let's see, what should I do next? A sun. I'll do a sun. Yes, yes. Of course, they're yellow, so I have to make that yellow.
Oh,
what if I did?
No, Teacher Connor, remember, no rules. You don't have to make the sun yellow. You can make it whatever color you want.
Oh, what about a beige sun?
Yeah.
Put that up there, a couple of lines for the beige rays. A nice beige day.
That's awesome.
I should probably add some grass, which of course is green. So let me grab my...
Teacher Connor, take a big deep breath and remember, no rules. It doesn't have to be green. If you want it to be green, it can be green, but it doesn't have to be green.
Okay. I guess I could try blue out. Let's see. And some more blue. Well, that's kind of fun. And I could make the doors, which are normally wood, which is brown. I'm gonna make them red.
Awesome.
And a little doorknob there, and maybe some green windows.
You're getting really creative now.
Awesome. And I could make a roof out of yellow, and I'll color this yellow here.
Love it.
Here,
you're getting so creative.
Oh no, Miss Britt, I messed up. I was trying to get the yellow on just the roof, and now there's this yellow mark that's way out there, and it's ruined. I need a new sheet of paper.
Hold on.
Awful. Oh gosh.
Teacher Connor, this happens sometimes.
It does?
There's a name for it. Sometimes when you're coloring or painting or really doing anything, you might make a mistake. And I like to call those mistakes a beautiful oops.
A beautiful oops?
Yeah. And here's the cool part about a beautiful oops. You could change your mistake into something new so that it doesn't feel so mistakey and instead feels like a beautiful oops.
Huh. Now that you mention it, you know what this kind of looks like?
Yeah.
It kind of looks like a little bit of a skateboard ramp on the roof there. And it just needs some supports here.
That is so creative.
Yeah. That's pretty cool. And I could draw a person right there. And they could be on a skateboard. Probably not recommended to do at home, but still, I'm pretty excited about how that turned out.
Your mistake on your roof turned into a totally awesome skateboard ramp that you would have never had if you wouldn't have had a beautiful oops.
Wow. Thanks, Miss Britt.
You're welcome. Do you guys think you could do some coloring at home? Maybe use all the colors in new ways. And if you make a beautiful oops, you can just keep going and change it into something that feels really special. Yeah? All right. Cool. Thanks, everyone. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Thanks for tuning in to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. Medford School District is a place where all are learning, and learning is for all.
My name is Lisa Rollman. I am a Title I specialist here at Howard. This is The Zone. Welcome. Students are welcome to come into The Zone either scheduled or unscheduled. Some kids will come when their lid is flipped and they just need to find a space to calm down and get their lid on. Their nervous system needs to regulate. Some kids will come in when their nervous system is pretty regulated, but they need to maintain regulation. And so if their lid is flipped, they're gonna go to one of the calming spaces. If they're ready to relate and reason, their lid is on, then they're gonna come over here and do the mood meter. Bryce, how are you feeling right now? Why don't we do you as an example? Let's remind him, what do we work on? Pleasantness, energy, mood, emotion.
Pleasantness is a plus 5.
And that is the x-axis, right? Plus 5 on the x-axis.
And my energy is a minus 1.
Energy is a minus 1, that's the y-axis. He landed right here again. So they come to this table. Anybody who comes to Howard can feel that it's radically calm. We still have kids that are dysregulated, kids that are learning how to regulate, but they can predict that the adult response is going to be one of radical calmness.